tonight on this edition of Christopher's Kitchen. Last time, if you recall, we showed you the various cuts of meat, and the worst thing that can happen is that you go and you invest money in that, and some more expensive than others, and then you ruin it once you get it home. We've all been guilty of that at one time or another. But Christopher, as far as preparation is concerned, depending on what cut of meat, depends on how much preparation that you and how much seasoning that you place on a piece of meat.
Right. I think the basic rule is keep it simple. At the restaurant, we're using prime beef. We just use salt and pepper, and we hope.
That's surprising to a lot of people.
I know. We hope to not to mess it up. The meat has enough flavor as it is. If you're cooking prime or real high graded choice, salt and pepper is probably the best thing. But if you want to, if you want a little bit more spice and things like that, I do have some seasonings, some of my favorite seasonings that I use at home because I can't afford prime.
All right, now one of the cuts here that you've got here is a real popular one in Texas, of course, right. And that is the grilled chicken, quite popular, and so is the fajita meat.
Right. If you were going to do chicken and beef feeds, I just want to tell you what I do at home, and if it helps somebody out there, also put these recipes on the website.
Okay.
So a lot of people do fajitas. Believe it or not, Mike, the best thing that I've found, and there's a lot more authentic recipes out there, I'm sure. I'm just telling you what's so simple and works so well. There used to be a dressing called Golden Italian Dressing out there that Kraft made. Now I think the best you can get is Zesty Italian. I marinate the beef fajita meat in that Zesty Italian dressing overnight, and the vinegar in that dressing makes the meat more tender. It just gets a great flavor. You'll be really happy. Now, I jazz it up a little bit every now and then with some chopped serrano peppers and some cilantro, and so I can put those optional things on the website also. Now for chicken, what I do for fajitas, and again, I'm not sure if it's very authentic or anything, I just know what works and what tastes really good, and that is a soy sauce and pineapple juice. If you marinate those chicken breasts in pineapple juice and soy sauce, and I'll give you the proportions, it gets sweet and salty, and it's just great for fajitas. I mean, whether it's authentic or not, I don't know, but I know that you'll have very happy guests. Now for our steaks, like ribeye, New York strips, tenderloin, and T-bones or porterhouses, basically I use just salt and pepper, but if I'm feeling a little bit, I want a little bit spicier, a little bit punchy, I do make a dry rub mix or a seasoning mix of salt, garlic powder, black pepper, and cayenne pepper. Okay, and I sprinkle that over the steak. That seems to be a real, and I'll give you a recipe for that mix. Seems to be a real good mix because I like mine a little spicy, so I put a little cayenne pepper in there and black pepper, and it seems to have a great flavor that way. It's more expensive cuts of meats, they don't need marination, although you can. I mean, a lot of times you can marinate a ribeye in the same marinade that you use for the chicken breast, and it's fantastic, like Hawaiian-type ribeye,
right.
Pineapple soy sauce. So if you're going to marinate or season something, you can season them and put them back in the refrigerator.
And for how long on something like this? Do you need to do the all-night, or can you do the all-night?
If I'm going to season something and then let it marinate, I never put salt in it, okay? So if you're going to season them ahead of time and you want them to marinate, don't put salt, because what salt does, it draws out moisture out of the meat. So if you want some marination on your steak, marinate it with all spices and leave it in the refrigerator overnight and put salt at the last minute before you grill it.
All right, let's go to our final two cuts here. Let's talk about the ribs here and the chicken, the whole chicken.
Well, now the rib is a little bit different. I use the exact same seasoning rub as I did here, but I add sugar to it, and I'll give you that recipe. It's sugar plus all those spices, the garlic, the black pepper, cayenne pepper, and salt. And I will go ahead and salt these because I want some salt to get in that meat. And also this chicken, you can use that same seasoning rub. I like to use the same one that I use for the ribs. I like a little sugar on that, also gives it a nice color. And one of the big crazes these days is to do a beer can chicken. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you've heard of that.
No.
But you open a beer, you season this chicken with those spices that I think that I mentioned that are great, and then you invert you poke a hole, I use Shiner Bock, open up a can of Shiner Bock, put the chicken over the beer like this, and then as that roasts in the oven, the beer evaporates and goes into the chicken and stuff, and it makes
good
it tender.
Good, you gotta be kidding.
I might show you that. Would you like to see that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Mike, one thing I also want to mention is steak sauce. So now, a lot of people will just serve, with these great meats, you could just serve them plain, no problem. But two steaks also that I love, and these companies are more than welcome to send me a check if they would like, but two sauces that I absolutely love is this tiger sauce. Mm-hmm. Now this is sweet and hot, and I love that with almost any steak. I wouldn't pour it on, but I think it's great.
Okay.
The other sauce, and we serve both these in the restaurant too because I like them. There's nothing wrong with the other steak sauces, but I think these are a little bit unique and fun.
Okay.
This is called pick-a-pepper sauce. If I read you the ingredients on this thing, you'd be shocked. It's got raisins and everything in there. It's really wild. But this is very spicy. It's kind of like a normal steak sauce. It's a more normal steak sauce. But it is great. I mean, it's a really good sauce. So those are two sauces I recommend with our grilled steaks here.
Once again, if you'd like to access the rubs and the different seasonings that we've been talking about here and the proportions that Christopher was mentioning earlier, you can do that on the webpage at kbtx.com. Click on the food page in the Christopher's Kitchen. You'll see all the recipes and all that information pop up right there. We'll see you next time for another edition of Christopher's Kitchen.